We have already made tons of videos on the subject of insulation, but now again to freshen it up and with the latest materials. We did a survey on Instagram. How important is insulation to you? And it's pretty clear already. 75% of all say that insulation is quite important, but 25% probably do not deal with the topic at all. What is this insulation myth? We are going to clarify the following questions today. Where does insulation even make sense? How does insulation actually work? Do you even need insulation? How complicated or how simple is it actually? How much time does it take? Which materials have to be used and how much do I actually need? What difficulties might I run into? Because I want to be sure that I'm doing everything right. Essentially, I can think of three points why you should do a door insulation. On one hand, there are disturbing background noises, such as vibrating, rattle and other noises that come out of the door and don't belong in the music. Also to minimize driving noise, so that you can enjoy the music better while driving and get fully involved.
Besser genießen kann und sich voll drauf einlassen kann. Und der dritte Punkt ist der,
thirdly, that we can better control the sound from the loudspeaker and get more bass out of it without rebuilding the loudspeaker system or requiring more power.
Umzubauen oder mehr Leistung drauf zu machen.
We usually have more bass just by insulating. As far as bass is concerned, I'll even show you today with our measuring device and a microphone.
Und einem Mikrofon genau zeigen.
Here we have a measurement from a program from Audiotech Fisher. We can set the frequency response of this vehicle with a special signal called pink noise. Every frequency is equally loud. That's why it starts here at 25 Hz over the entire listening range up to 20 kHz. We are only interested in the lower area of the bass, which we will measure now. Once from the entire front system and once only from the right side. I'll do that for you now and then we'll look at it again. This is what pink noise sounds like. Now we have two curves, which we will save. We have a red curve, which picks up both speakers, the whole front system. The blue curve is just the right side. Now we insulate the doors, especially on the right-hand side, and can then do another comparison measurement. Now we insulate the doors, and I'll be back straight away and show you how to proceed. Then I'll put the door trim back on again, and we'll see you again at the measurement, and see what the whole insulation really has done. Then again, pink noise! Let's take a look at the result. Now we see the line here. The first was the red line. We measured them. Those are both front speakers and the green one is the new line. And now here we see plus 3 dB, plus 3 dB, plus 4 dB, plus 4 dB, plus 3 dB. Here is only plus 1 dB at 50 Hz, here at 40 Hz again, plus 4 dB, and at 32 Hz, plus 6 dB. So that's really a massive increase just for insulating the door. These are exactly the same speakers. Now let's look at what we measured earlier. The right speaker is the blue line and the new measurement with insulation is the yellow line. Here you see how much bass we gained. Up to 7 dB at 100 Hz, 8 dB at 80 Hz, the bass range is extreme. We don't need to be very interested in this up here. This is where the fun factor in listening to music lies. How to get such a result in the bass range in order to have more fun, I'll show you now with the materials and how to deal with them and what exactly to use. In this video, we will also show you a few things in practice and also introduce all of the products. But first of all, we just clarify where does it make sense to insulate. In our case, the door, because we are acoustic specialists. We are installing new loudspeakers and want the loudspeakers to perform at their best, and we have to see how the door is set up. I would like to show you what a loudspeaker actually does. It moves, at least the membrane, and that means we have vibrations. When I mount the entire loudspeaker system on a sheet of metal, everything starts to vibrate and rattle a bit at higher levels. This is noticeable in the form of audible vibrations or in the quality of sound.
Oder natürlich auch, und jetzt kommt's, im Sound, in der Qualität des Sounds.
If the loudspeaker in the door panel can more or less do what it wants and is not fixed and held in place, then the bass will also be less. It sounds bad. On the other hand, if it is probably insulated and the loudspeaker is screwed into place in a very stable manner, then the bass becomes really impulsive. You really get that feeling, and it's not just a feeling, it's measurable, more bass. It all sounds much clearer. Do you even need insulation? Yes! If you are installing new loudspeakers in your door and want to achieve the best possible performance, then it always makes sense to insulate.
Eigentlich immer sinnvoll.
You have to look at how you approach the matter, because what does insulation do? Insulation does nothing other than prevent the light sheet metal from moving on which the loudspeaker is screwed onto, which is not so stable that it does not vibrate when the loudspeaker starts to move. It is only held in place by a bit of sheet metal. The lighter the sheet metal, the more the whole loudspeaker can vibrate, and this has a correspondingly negative effect on the sound. We are now primarily trying to hold the loudspeaker firmly in place by making the area where the loudspeaker is screwed onto the sheet metal heavier. If something is heavy, it can't be moved that easy because it is heavier, and accordingly, we counteract precisely this vibration with this insulation. What else does insulation do? If you do it right, the whole door gets a lot quieter.
Eben wesentlich ruhiger.
Also, you probably all know it when there are any keyrings or something in the door.
In der box praktisch in der Türe mit drin sind.
You throw it in there carelessly and somehow there are suddenly a lot of background noises, because the door, when you turn up the volume, starts to swing and a lot of background noises arise. These small background noises can arise anywhere around the door, on small switches, on badly clipped clips or other parts that start to vibrate. The quieter I get the whole door and take care of every single part, the better it is. The result will be in the end, and the whole passenger cell is much quieter. So I can pay much more attention to what is happening in my music. How difficult is it to insulate, and how long does it take for something like that? Now we have to assume that you normally insulate when you already install new loudspeakers in the door. So it's always the same procedure. First, dismantle the door panel. We have enough videos on our channel in which we show you exactly that. You can take a look around there. Now we come to the point that the door panel is already completely dismantled and we have the sheet metal surfaces or plastic paneling free in front of us and only have to treat and stick our self-adhesive material accordingly. How long does it take? I estimate between 1 or 2 hours for an amateur, maybe more like 2 hours. Anyone who has already done something like this can do it in an hour. Take your time, it's worth it. To the question, how much insulation do I need per door or for 2 doors? We have already created different sets for you for this purpose. There is the light set, the premium set, the pro set, and even an extreme set. If you have a normal door, 3 such aluminum butyl insulation mats are usually sufficient.
So 3 solche Dämmmatten, Alu, Butyl.
In addition, an insulating foam mat. Then you've actually came a long way. The bigger the door and the more surfaces you can stick on, the more material you need. In general, you could also say that there isn't too much insulation, but at some point it just becomes ineffective if I put another layer on top of it again and again and again. Then only the door becomes unnecessarily heavy without hearing any meaningful effect. Then we come to the materials and there are actually not that many different things. It's pretty straightforward. Let's start with the aluminum butyl insulation mat. That's this mess here. This is butyl and a very thin layer of aluminum to hold everything together, to fix it in place and to introduce a second layer.
Zu fixieren und natürlich eine zweite Schicht einzuführen.
Everything that is built up in layers becomes more and more stable. That means we can glue this material to sheet metal parts to increase the weight there.
Aufkleben, um dort das Gewicht zu erhöhen.
Over a large area or in several layers.
Schichten oder mehreren Lagen.
The main thing is a lot of weight at the point where the loudspeaker is mounted, because that is where its center of movement is.
Ist ja das Epizentrum der Bewegung.
That's where we add the most. The more insulation I install on the other end of the door panel, the less it will do.
Montier, umso weniger guten Effekt habe ich dabei. Kann man zwar machen, aber irgendwann wird.
At some point it becomes less effective, so concentrate around the speaker area. It is recommended to wear gloves in any case, because the aluminum can be sharp when you cut it and you can cut yourself with it.
Vielleicht scharf sein kann, kleine Schnittchen am Fleisch passieren könnten.
Use gloves, then the problem is gone. You can also use this roller to attach the material to the sheet metal and so you hardly have to touch it.
Dann braucht das auch gar nicht großartig in die Hand nehmen.
So such a roller is very practical. You can glue the aluminum butyl to the outer sheet, on the outermost sheet metal of the door, to also insulate it. Often you can get to the outer sheet for insulation through the loudspeaker openings or other openings in the sheet metal.
Und da kann ich dann das Außenblech dämmen.
As a rule, either a quarter to a half mat is sufficient. We can save the rest for the actual sheet metal on which the loudspeaker is mounted. We can also use this aluminum butyl to get the door panel quiet. If yours has such a thin cladding made of cardboard, the material can also be used to bring more weight from behind on smooth surfaces in order to bring more rigidity into the cladding.
Gewicht drauf zu bringen, um mehr Steifheit in den ganzen reinzubringen.
First, clean the sheets on which you are sticking the aluminum butyl properly, so that everything can stick, and you should absolutely rub the aluminum butyl on without bubbles, so that all of the butyl is placed on the sheet metal. Let's get to our acoustic foam. The foam can do several things. With it, you can make the area around the loudspeaker on the door paneling quiet and dampen it, so that the sound, which does not go straight through the grill, is absorbed and not reflected back to the membrane.
Dass der Schall, der nicht direkt geradeaus durch das Gitter durchgeht und auch in die Fahrgastzelle soll, der Rest aber absorbiert wird und nicht wieder zu Reflexionen auf die Membran zurück kann.
In this respect, we are happy to apply this foam to the areas around the loudspeaker grill or larger areas.
Oder größere Flächen.
We can attach it there. It's very easy to apply. You should only attach it to areas of the door panel that remain dry.
Da, wo es auch trocken ist, das wäre eigentlich an der Stelle ein.
A good hint at this point. Let's come to my favorite material, bitumen tape. It can be used in many ways. We have it by the meter. You can divide it into small pieces and make them very thin.
In kleinen Stücken und es ganz dünn machen.
Extremely thin. For example, to attach such rattling clips, if they are already a bit worn out, then it may be that they start rattling in the small sheet metal hole when they swing. You can now wrap it around the clip.
Masse ein bisschen um den Clip drumherum.
If you put it in now, it will be actually quiet.
Tatsächlich ruhig und macht keine Mucken mehr.
Window regulator switches can start rattling over time, and you can use a very fine screwdriver to stuff a little bit of this bitumen into the slots.
In die Schlitzchen rein stopfen.
Also not much, just a little, so that the switches are held in place with a bitumen. You can't see them afterwards, but that little vibration is gone too. There are always cables hanging around in the car door that have to be clamped to the door panel and plugged in. That means that they could possibly start vibrating when they hit metal or something, and I can also make a small strip with bitumen tape and make sure that the cables are fixed really well, and then nothing can vibrate anymore. Everything will be totally quiet. Perhaps you can think of a few other situations where the bitumen tape can be useful. There are no more limits to your imagination. Next, we come to the speaker ceiling tape. You can stick the tape on the speakers from behind. Then you can fix the speaker on this foam rubber strip and screw it on.
Praktisch festmachen und festschrauben.
You could take it out again without anything sticking to it. In any case, the loudspeaker is then installed tightly and also vibration-free. Speaker ceiling tape. We come to a problem that many older vehicles have, which are holes in the metal sheets. That sounds a bit stupid, but we also have an example. You can see that next to the loudspeaker there are holes and recesses that minimize the weight of the door. That doesn't really help us with acoustic construction. It's very negative, so we have to make sure to improve something here. When I lift the loudspeaker in the air, you know there is no bass coming out. This is called an acoustic short circuit. The rear membrane is connected to the front one. And that means that no sound pressure can arise. So we try to seal off the rear area of the membrane from the front. That's actually the point. If I have such a large hole next to my loudspeaker, there is practically a partial acoustic short circuit. Now noise flex comes into play. Noise flex is a hard cardboard that is also provided with an adhesive layer on one side, and with this hard cardboard you can primarily mask these holes by adapting the cardboard to the shape of the hole and masking it. Now I have a hard layer where I can glue my aluminum butyl directly over it and then build the whole thing like a wall around the loudspeaker.
Und kann das Ganze jetzt wie eine Wand aufbauen, die rings um den Lautsprecher drumherum ist.
Last but not least, we have a nap foam. So a nap foam without an adhesive layer. We also have one with an adhesive layer that is more likely to be used in bass boxes. Nap foam itself can do a lot of things. For example, this crossover. There are still plenty of speaker systems that require installing such crossovers in the door. You can wrap it up nicely and then place it somewhere vibration-free. Such a crossover doesn't get hot, that means you can also wrap them. It's just important that it doesn't start to rattle and roll around somewhere. You can put a bit of electrical tape around it. Now the thing is neatly packed and the foam, the knobs, make everything very quiet. You have to be very clear that the bigger the loudspeaker, the more effective the door insulation gets. If you have such a small mid-range driver, only 8 or 10 cm big, it hardly makes any movement. It hardly makes any bass either. That means, if we have a BMW with such a mid-range speaker in the door and the actual subwoofer under the seat, then the greatest door insulation will do you relatively little. Except for a little less driving noise. But the bigger the loudspeaker in the door is, we're talking about 13 cm, 16 cm, there is something going on, and there are also enough vehicles with even larger 20 cm loudspeakers. They really push and bring in movement. With our insulation package and what you have just learned, you have real wellness for your ears and soul. Isn't that just awesome? Here, for example, we have a Ford Escort from the 90s. Since the new loudspeaker unit is now being installed and we have already removed the cladding, we can now see this foam rubber mat here as well. So not that bad for the insulation, but it also moves And it is exactly this acoustic short circuit that I was talking about. Everything has to go. We make everything new, even if it looks good. With such a noise flex mat, you have to be careful. It's a hard mat. If we stick them on to seal it and then stick our aluminum butyl on it, then we have a problem.
Unser Alubutyl drauf zu kleben, dann haben wir ein Problem und zwar.
On the back wall of the door panel, you can see this cavity from the front. This is arched backwards. At this point, the material would be too hard and I can no longer attach the door panel to where it was before. At this point, we can't work with noise flex, but we actually have to lay two mats with aluminum butyl on top of each other. And now we can bulge it out nicely. I'll show it to you now. Let's start by folding it in here to model the corresponding cavity again.
Um den entsprechenden Hohlraum wieder zu modellieren.
Now we have the corresponding cavity. It's still a bit soft now, although it is already much firmer than the material before, and now you can put a second layer on top, and then the whole thing will be firm. That's really firm. If you just stick the mats on it, please make sure that the existing screw holes, from which you removed the screws, remain free. Also pay attention to the sides. All holes for the screws must remain free. Holes like these that are not covered by the door panel can be masked over and sealed off. Another tip is good tools. If you don't already have something like that to remove door panels and plastic parts, I can only recommend our remover tool with various shapes. This way you can get under the paneling. Highly recommended. A complete Torx kit for those who don't have it at home. Most new doors don't have Phillips head screws, but Torx. There are also vehicles with an airbag in the door. This means that we have to be careful not to tape over the predetermined breaking point on the door panel. It is usually very well marked, so that you know what I mean by a thin styrofoam mat. Something like this here. This is not original, because someone has already glued something over it. It has probably already been taken away without using the original mat, or it has torn. These noises, there are enough foils, which look exactly like a thin styrofoam mat and crackle a lot. You can get rid of them, just away with it. Although, as with the Alpha 156 or many other vehicles, there is already a bit of sound deadening on the sheet metal. It all sounds very hollow.
Klingt das alles sehr hohl, ja?
We'll knock on it again soon. Short update. Sounds already in any case completely different from before, and it goes on. Noise flags attached, next knock test. A little bit better again. I think you can hear it pretty clearly now. Nothing rattles anymore. I hope you learned something here. You have to decide whether you do it yourself or not. We definitely recommend it. You can also visit us on Instagram. We have a lot of news for you at the moment about our company, about the topic of car hi-fi. A lot is happening there right now, have a look too. If you don't want to miss any video, click the bell here on YouTube. Until next time, you're Olli.